In this morning's Health Watch, as science helps advance medicine, we're seeing patient care improve with surgeries getting less invasive. MedStar Heart and Vascular Institute performed the DMV's first robotic heart surgery. Joining us now is Dr. Yuji Kawano, director of the new program at MedStar Washington, and patient Brian Cohn. Good morning to both of you. Good to see you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Dr. Kawano, I want to start with you. We know this is the first robotic heart surgery program in the area, but MedStar does have robotic surgeries in other specialties. How significant is this?
It is very significant, and we are so excited about this and then for being able to offer this option for our patients. I think robotic surgery is an excellent option for, selected patients because it can provide, less invasive option, obviously, and then also so much less pain, post-operative pain, and quick recovery, and then also less complications along with the surgery.
Yeah, I was going to ask.
We can get same,
You can get same or better results. I'm sorry, you can continue.
Right. Yes, that's correct.
I was going to ask you, just for some perspective here, with traditional heart surgery, what all does it involve? I mean, how much more invasive is it?
Yeah, that's a great question. So traditional cardiac surgery, when we do heart surgery, we have to open in the middle of the chest like this. And then there's a, a fair amount of the size of the scar here. But by doing a robotic approach, I don't have to, open in the middle. I just go from by side and it only requires small incisions. Mm. I think that's really great for patients.
Yeah, it's a big, big difference. Brian, I want to move on to you here. You got this surgery April 19th. You were discharged just 3 days later. I'm curious, when you heard you would be the first patient with this robotic surgery in the area, how did you feel about that?
I didn't have the trepidation that many of my friends and family had, because I know that Dr. Kawano had trained with the pioneer in this technology, who had performed thousands. I think he's the world record holder, and Dr. Kawano has performed hundreds of these surgeries himself. It's been around for 20 years, and it's statistically equal or better than the alternative, which is a incision from my navel to my neck. I was home in 3 days, and
wow.
I have had to take maybe two Tylenol. That's about it.
Well, when you look good, you sound good. What would you say to other patients who perhaps are, going to be the second, third, coming after you, as far as maybe preparing or the after effects?
Well, I think Dr. Kawano's already had second and third, but if you want to get in line, I would definitely talk to Dr. Kawano. Dr. Kawano is trained in all forms of heart surgery, so if you meet with him, he can offer you any alternative that any cardiothoracic surgeon can offer. But if you can qualify for this alternative, as opposed to 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 months recovering from the sternum approach, and you could get back to your family within days. Oh. I try to describe it, differently to everyone, but it's like power steering and power brakes versus, a horse and buggy. I don't know.
Dr. Kawano, I want to wrap with you because we're out of time here, but what would be the next frontier? What's the next technological advancement that you would want to see that would make your job even easier?
Okay. Yeah. Even though the robotic approach is a really great option, but still there are fields that I cannot use this technology to certain pathologies. I think down the road, I think we will see, this robotic technology will be applied to these diseases too.
Yeah. Well, Brian is proof of the significant difference it can make when you start to include robotic surgeries, in this case, when it comes to cardiac surgeries. Dr. Yuji Kawano and Brian, glad you are doing well this morning. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.